Hello, my name is Jack Sifri, and in this video demo, I will show you how to generate X-parameter models from circuit-level designs using ADS. Agilent has recently announced this breakthrough technology in X-parameter model generation for components used in wireless and aerospace and defense industries. These X parameters can be generated from both simulation using ADS and measurement using the NVNA for faster design development. In this video demo, I will focus on generating X parameters from circuit-level designs using ADS. For this demo, I have designed this two-stage MMIC power amplifier for LTE application. I want to show you how to generate the X parameters for this PA and share it with the system integrator for higher up system level simulation and analysis. You see, the system integrator, who might be thousands of miles away from the design house, is able to receive this accurate IP protected model within minutes and then insert it into their system for faster system simulation and trade-off analysis. Before I go on with the demo, let me briefly explain what are X parameters. Just like S parameters used for small signals, X parameters are used to describe the behavior of components in response to large signals. In fact, X parameters reduce exactly to S parameters in the small signal limit, and they have the same simple use model as S parameters, but they are much more powerful because they contain information on all the harmonics and intermodulation spectra generated in response to large signals. Furthermore, X parameters includes and accurately models the effects of mismatch between cascaded modules at the fundamental and harmonics and even at the intermodulation frequencies. X parameter models are highly accurate and much faster in simulation speed. They protect your design's IP and allow you to share them with others without revealing the nature of your design topologies. Generating X parameters is fast and easy in ADS. Let me show you how. All I have to do is insert my PA into this template, which consists of X parameter source, load, and bias, all accessible from the simulation X parameter pull-down menu shown on the left here. So all I have to do next is click on the simulate button, and in few seconds an X parameter model is generated that I can email to the system integrator for immediate use. And this is how the generated model looks like. It contains all incident and scattered signals at all ports, at all frequencies, power levels, and at all other swept parameters such as bias, temperature, and other. This is exactly what the system integrator would receive, and your design IP and topology is fully protected. Next, using harmonic balance, I want to simulate both the model and the circuit level PA so I can compare the results. Here, I simulate the model, and this is the results coming from the model. Next, I will do the same thing for the power amplifier circuit level, and I click on simulate, and the results come out as shown on the screen. In order to best compare the model and circuit level results, here are the results overlaid on top of each other. This clearly shows the magnitude and phase of the fundamental, second harmonic, and third harmonic being right on top of each other. This demonstrates that the X parameters model have the same accuracy as the real circuit. So the system integrator can insert this model now into this system and use it as having the real circuit level PA in the system. And by the way, I want to point out here that X parameters models can be easily generated as well for mixers and other nonlinear components in the system. And the system integrator can use them to perform faster system simulation and characterization with full accuracy. It's really identical to having the actual circuit level designs in the system. The model I have just generated was done with single tone and 50 ohms load. It works very well in a system that contains cascaded 50 ohms matched modules. In fact, the model is good and accurate within 2-to-1 visuar around 50 ohms. But what if I have large mismatch between cascaded modules, not only at the fundamental, but at higher harmonics? We need to generate a load-dependent model that would accurately account for this mismatch, especially in cascaded modules in the system. And this would be the topic of the next demo, part 2. Let me recap. In this demo, part 1, we generated a model with single tone and 50-ohm load. In part 2, we will sweep the load and generate a load-dependent model that will hold accurate in cascaded mismatched modules. In part 3, I will show you how to generate a two-tone model that can be used to determine the intermodulation distortion products and third-order intercept. And finally, in part 4, I will show how the X-parameter model is used in wireless verification with much faster simulation and verification speed. Thank you for watching this demo. For more information on X-parameters, please refer to the following two web pages. Please proceed next to video demo number 2 on load pull techniques. Thank you.